Big over in right, counter right hand, clutching his head in the wind with patience, with class, with power for Chris Cesaro.
What's going on, guys? Chris Cesaro here. Today's quarantine vlog number 2. We're going to be going over the cross, and it's brought to you by the Canna Bio Group. This is a company we are really excited with. They're on the bottom floor right now, working their way up. But they're smart people and they're good businessmen. They drove up from Connecticut to meet with my manager, give us a bunch of products, sign on to Team Golden Gloves. I tried their product out last night. My sciatic has been flared like crazy because I'm a big silverback gorilla trying to make it in this little small people world. And I just don't, I don't bounce out of bed like I used to. I got some aches and pains. This product right here, I tried their, these are still in the lab. So their website's gonna be up soon. We'll be able to give you guys a code, go on there, order their product. I swear by this stuff, it works. Their full spectrum CBD hemp 300 milligram CBD topical cream. Put right on my back, felt like a bunch of little fingers. Massaging my back felt amazing. It relieved the pain. I was able to sit for 2 hours, watch a movie. Same spot, that's rare. Anyways, burning over the cross today. Now, the cross is, I call it my money maker. You know, if you follow it, any of my fights, they tend to all end with the right hand. But you go back in the amateurs, I was dropping people with an uppercut, with hooks. Bunch of different names. I choose to call it the money maker because when I land it, makes me money. It's your powerful punch. Now, say in the streets, you know, you don't have time to set your jab up and get your range and all this stuff. Say it's a serious situation. You know, I like to just keep my hands up like this. I kind of gauge where I'm at, and if I feel the situation's going south, I'll get them before they get me. And I don't have time to set anything else up that always seems to take the cake. Now, to set up your right hand, as in the first vlog I told you, you always set it up with your jab. It's the same point of destination, right there and right there. It's the same ending point, which is your opponent's face, his jaw, his nose, temple, throat, wherever it lands, it lands. If thrown right, it'll do what it's supposed to do. Now, by being thrown right, you gotta be completely balanced here. You know, we can't be standing in a completely vertical stance where our foundation's got cracks in it. We have to have a strong foundation. Both toes pointing at about 2 o'clock-ish in there. You know, one foot pointing this way, one foot pointing that way, that's your energy. I want all my energy going the same way, so when I throw the cross, lined up with my opponent, I lay my jab, my cross comes right down the line. Now I'm completely balanced here. You could push me left to right, I'm not going anywhere, I'm a rock.
Punch. Hopefully they've been watching the back and see that happens. Sometimes you're gonna get knocked out.
Big over in right, counter right hand, clutching his head and down.
Now, my shoulder's completely pulled back. My toes at a slight arch here. I got a slight bend, boom. You don't want to be bending all the way down doing a lunge. Just a little bit of a drop, that's gravity. Now, the force, it travels up as everything turns at the same time. As my foot turns, it activates my calf, which activates my quad, comes up into my core, my obliques, comes out from my chest, shoulders, boom. To throw across properly, you can just push your punch up there. That's just the weight of your arm swinging. Now, part of having my elbows in, when I rotate everything, boom, it comes off of my body strong, like a 2x4. You don't want to walk into the back of a 2x4, it's going to be a bad day. A 2x4 with a little pressure crack in it, you can push right through that thing. But you want everything to be connected and solid. You want your body to be doing the work. You don't want to be pushing your arm. You think that bench pressing is going to get you a strong punch. It doesn't work that way. It's a full body process here. So if you go over my knockouts, I mean, my whole body's engaged. Boom, I'm turned right over. Boom, everything behind that. You wanted to make that noise. And a good knockout, you shouldn't even feel. But after a win that I had back in September, it was a one-punch knockout. I look over to Glenn Cugno, my old boxing coach, and he goes, "How'd it feel? I'm still in the cage." And I go, "Didn't feel a thing." He goes, "Exactly. Because the best, you don't feel at all. It's like hitting a pillow. Nice, clean. You know, if you go to break the board, boom, and you don't hit it hard enough, that's a bad day for your hand. When you do break the board, boom, your power goes all the way through it, you don't feel nothing. So, if anything, guys, throw proper punches, throw straight down the line, you know, throw with bad intentions, it'll be an easy night for you. So, again, thank you for joining me. Let's work together, guys. Power in numbers here. I don't like being stuck inside any more than the other guy or girl. So, let's be strong. I love you all. Love your neighbors. Power in numbers. We're Americans. We persevere. Golden Gate.